गुड इवनिंग डॉक्टर्स, वेलकम अगेन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट असाइड्स। असाइड्स इज प्रेजेंट्स व्हेन देयर इज एकुमुलेशन ऑफ फ्री फ्लूइड इन पेरिटोनियल कैविटी। व्हाट इज असाइड्स व्हेन फ्री फ्लूइड्स इन पेरिटोनियल कैविटी? रिमेंबर, सैक, इट्स सीरम असाइटिस एल्बुमिन ग्रेडियंट इज कंसिडर्ड द मोस्ट सेंसिटिव एंड स्पेसिफिक मैथड ऑफ कैटेगराइजिंग असाइड्स। It is calculated by subtraction the ascitic fluid albumin value from the serum albumin value. It correlates directly with portal hypertension. Okay, now ascites are two types, exudative, transudative. I will explain you here. In exudative ascites, we see serum ascites albumin gradient is less than 11 gram per liter, but if serum proteins we see, serum proteins is more than 30 grams per liter. Okay, remember this. And malignancy is an example of ascites, exudative, hepatic, peritoneal common. Infective like tuberculosis, pancreatitis, nephrotic syndrome, lymphatic obstruction, hypothyroidism is a rare. So these are the causes of exudative ascites, and remember, in exudative ascites like serum albumin, ascites albumin gradient is less than 11 gram per liter and serum proteins are more than 30 grams per liter. Okay. Whereas in transudative ascites, we see SAG as SWAG. Its serum ascites albumin gradient is more than 11 grams per liter, okay, whereas serum proteins is less than 30 grams per liter. So what are the causes of transudative ascites? Is liver cirrhosis, cardiac failure, Budd-Chiari syndrome, sinusoidal obstruction syndrome, protein losing enteropathy, malnutrition, mixed syndrome rare, and constrictive pericarditis is rare. So these are the causes of transudative ascites. Okay, now how to investigate, how to diagnose ascites? It is ultrasonography is the best mean of detecting ascites. Ascites amylase activity of more than 100 unit per liter identify pancreatic ascites. Remember guys, when ascites amylase is more than 1000 unit per liter, then it is pancreatic ascites. Whereas neutrophil counts more than 200, it strongly suggests infection and is spontaneous bacterial peritonitis. If triglycerides level at more than 1.1 gram per liter, diagnostic of chylous ascites. Cytological examination may reveal malignant cells. Okay, in abdominal TB, should always be suspect in severely malnourished patients. High ascitic WBC, mainly lymphocytes, are found. Laparoscopy and peritoneal biopsy is diagnostic in 95% of cases. Okay, management. In case of exudative ascites, we treat it with, remember, paracentesis. In exudative ascites, paracentesis. But fluid replacement is generally not required. Remember only two things, paracentesis and fluid replacement not required, generally not required in exudative. Whereas treatment of transudative ascites based on restricting sodium and water intake. You have to restrict sodium and water intake, but promoting urine output with diuretics. In exudative, remember two things, paracentesis and fluid replacement not required. In transudative, we do restricting sodium and water intake, promoting urine output by diuretics. If necessary, removing ascites directly by paracentesis. Okay. Now, transjugular intrahepatic portosystemic stent shunt can relieve resistance ascites but not prolong the life. So guys, I hope till here it's very much clear for you regarding ascites. Your concepts are clear. If you have any queries, any question regarding ascites, you can ask me. And if you're new on my channel, please subscribe it. If you like this video, put like on it. Thank you. Good day. Goodbye. That's all for today.